Hello, and thank you for joining me today. My name is Neil Verhege. I'm an academic advisor for Milwaukee Area Technical College Healthcare Services Pathway. What I'm here to show you today is how to do the self-service, self-registration, so that you can register for classes for these upcoming semesters. And for a starting off point, I'd like to start at the matc.edu homepage. And we're just going to continue through the step-by-step process as a tutorial to discover the different ways to register for classes. So from the MATC homepage, you will look at the upper right-hand corner here, and you'll select the menu box. And scrolling down, you want to choose Student Staff Login. And then you will be brought to multiple additional MATC websites. And in the middle of the page here, you will choose Self-Service. Now for the first sign-in page, you just enter your username. So that is everything preceding the at symbol in your email address. And you enter your username, press continue. And then it brings you to a second page where you do have to type in your full email address. So once we log in here, you'll see your home screen. Now your home screen will look different than mine because I am an advisor. I do have other options. But if you look at the left-hand toolbar, you'll see that there's different options like home, financial information, and academics. You are gonna wanna choose academics, and then student planning, and then plan and schedule when you're ready to schedule for courses or register for courses. When you first log in here, you will see usually the current semester, and we are now in the semester of summer of 2020. And that these two arrows on the side here will allow you to toggle forward or backwards in time. So if you click the right arrow, you will advance to fall of 2020. Now, if you've already had a conversation with your advisor, they may have planned courses for you, and those courses will appear on this left-hand column. If they haven't planned anything, nothing will appear here, and you can search and register for your own courses, but we'll get to that in just a minute. So as we have courses here, you will see that Natural Science Basic Chemistry, 5 credits starting August 30th, 2020, has been planned for me. Here I can just go ahead and register for the section that is planned. So Natural Science 110, that's the department and course number, and the 002 is the section number. We can also view other available sections. So each department, each course has different available sections. So the same course taught with by a different instructor at different times, in different buildings, on different campuses. So as you can kind of look at the different options here, you can see that some are at the Mequon campus, some are considered online classes. So you can kind of scroll through and view all these possible options. What we're going to do is just select one of these in-person Mequon campus. As you can see, some of the information available here is that there are 19 seats available, and this is section 004, Basic Chemistry. The instructor name, the time in which it meets. So this class meets Wednesday and Thursday from 8:30 to 10:25. Mequon campus, A building, room 238. And there's also an additional lab that meets Monday from 8:30 to 10:25. So when I select that class, it pops up this window here and it kind of reiterates the information there, and you can click Add Section. Once you add a section, it plans it for you. So I added section 004 because I'm looking to take this course at the Mequon campus. My advisor might have scheduled a different section, but I can just easily remove that by selecting that X right there. So now that section is removed. Now I can, the advisor has already planned for me psychology 199, Psychology of Human Relations. So I'll go through that same process again and view other sections. And again, I get this list here, And as I hover over each section, it highlights in the schedule page the time and days in which that class meets. So here, this course is taught at the Oak Creek campus on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. I'm not looking to take classes at Oak Creek. I want to take another class at the Mequon campus. So here I'm looking at Mequon campus on Tuesdays and Thursdays at the same time. So I want to select that, so I'll just click right on it. Again, you get the pop-up menu, so I'm going to add section. Now, having added these sections, it just allows me to look at how this is going to lay out for my upcoming semester. I am not registered for this class yet, but you can see how my schedule will play out, and there's definitely no conflicts of time. Now, the advisor and I might have talked about a class that wasn't planned because of my work schedule or some other reason. We didn't go ahead and plan it, but I checked my work schedule and I can take another class for certain. So I will go up to search for courses, and another required class I have is Social Science 203. So I just type that into the search bar and press enter, and it's going to return Social Science 203 and a bunch of other classes as well that are near matches. So before I select that, I just want to make sure that I'm filtering these results by the fall semester. And I can filter by location, I can filter by days of the week, there's many options to filter these searches by. So I then, at this point, now it's filtered for fall, I can view available sections right here on the screen. As I'm looking at this, I can see that all of these classes are online sections. So it doesn't matter what campus I take it at. I will just be required to log in and complete assignments on a weekly basis. I will have deadlines, but I will be free at my leisure to complete these assignments as long as I hit the deadlines. So I am going to choose Social Science 203, section 803. I'm going to add that section to my schedule. Same pop-up menu, just click add section once more, and it's been added to my schedule. I do a back to plan and schedule, and it happens to drop me back off at summer, so I want to forward to my fall semester. So natural science, basic chemistry is still planned. Psychology is still planned, and now there's a new one, Introduction to Sociology. Notice how that does not appear on the schedule as it is an online class and doesn't have required meeting times or locations. So once you have this, there is essentially one more step to be considered registered. So you'll come here, and on the left-hand column, you can register for individual classes by clicking on the Register button. Once you click on that, it'll just go ahead and register you. It'll say registered but not started, meaning you're registered for the class, but the class has not started yet. Notice now that that register button has turned to a drop button. So if I was within the drop time frame, I could still drop this course and not be charged any fees or have any consequences for dropping it. Now the other two classes, I want to show you another way to register. The simple way, so once you plan everything, you can use the upper right-hand button and click Register Now. When you do that, it will take all the other classes that you have planned and register them. Good. Now we can see that all three of my classes are registered and not started. You know, if you made a mistake, you can easily click on the drop button and click Update, and you will drop that course. We're going to go ahead and drop all these courses, so Psychology 199 we're going to drop, and then we are also going to drop the Sociology class. So real quickly we can see that these classes go back to the fact that they were planned. They're not registered, they're just planned. So you can re-register in a different section, or if you wanted to change things around, you have the ability to do that fairly simply. If you don't want to see these in your plan section anymore, you can click that X and it'll remove them from being planned. So that's a basic tutorial on how to add and drop classes using self-service at MATC. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to your advisor and they can help you walk through the process. Thank you.